Seoul is one of the most vibrant cities in Asia due to its entertainment, culture, advanced technology, and cutting-edge design. The country's culture has helped in attracting several businesses to its cities. Seoul has built a LEED Gold-certified skyscraper with mixed-use facilities that became the fifth tallest building in the world. The tower became one of the most visited tourist destinations and a symbol of the country's economic growth. In the November of 2010, permission to build Lotte World Tower was approved, but the construction began in 2011. After 6 years of construction, the tower was opened to the public in 2017. Rising to 555 meters, Lotte World Tower is the tallest building in South Korea. The gross floor area of the tower is similar to the size of 115 soccer fields. The super tall structure with 123 floors has made several records: the fifth tallest building in the world, third tallest in Asia, and the first tallest in South Korea. The skyscraper set several Guinness World Records in 2017 for the highest glass floor observation deck, the tallest double-deck elevator, the fastest double-deck lift, the largest cinema screens. The mixed-use complex was constructed by the Lotte Group and designed by Kohn Pedersen Fox Associates. The building contains retail, entertainment, offices, residences, hotel, and an observatory on the top. The total cost of the tower accounted for about $2.5 billion. And by 2019, the tower has seen 13 million visitors a year. Located far from other skyscrapers in the city, the designers provided an iconic skyline. Seoul has built a vertical city that offers diversity, which is normally seen in linear horizontal urban centers. The pale color and tapering form of the building was inspired by the curvature and simple beauty seen in traditional Korean art forms of ceramics, porcelain, and calligraphy. The public amenities were spread throughout the building and not just on the ground floors, so that people would visit the upper floor areas. Restaurant, gallery, and observation deck are designed on the top floors to attract more visitors. The first 10 stories of the podium have Lotte World Mall with retail, entertainment, and cultural spaces. Office spaces, conference halls, events, meeting, and training areas occupy floor 11 to 39. Office Tell covers up to floor 75. From floor 76 to 107, the city's visitors can experience a luxury 7-star hotel with landmark design and facilities. The observatory, located on the top floors of the tower, provides the public with incredible views of the city. The tower contains the world's highest swimming pool, which is located on the 85th floor, and the world's fastest elevator, which can take people to the topmost floors in only 60 seconds. The building has a remarkable structural system. The skyscraper is built on mat foundation, a superstructure that runs 71.7 meter long, 6.5 meter thick, and volume of 31,203 meter square, which handles the vertical load of the entire structure. The weight of the concrete in tower's foundation is about 7 times the weight of the entire Eiffel Tower. The central core, 8 mega columns, and system of belt and outrigger trusses form the main structural components of the tower. The mega columns are spaced 25 meters apart on the perimeter of the tower, providing unrestricted views of the city in column-free office spaces. The core walls in the middle of the skyscraper that goes up to 123rd floor manage 60% of the tower's load, while the 8 mega columns that are placed around the perimeter of the tower manages the remaining 40%. One of the huge challenges to build a super tall building is the wind. Typhoons and heavy rainfall being common in Korea, the building was designed with wind-resistant features, which can withstand a strong wind of 80 meters per second, which is the highest typhoon level. The 120 meter high roof structure is built using 12 meter high steel counterparts, each weighing 20 tons. The building was also made to resist strong earthquakes. The tower has an incredible seismic design that can withstand an earthquake of magnitude 9.0 on the Richter scale, which is higher than the Burj Khalifa. To identify any structural issues or disaster-related events, the monitoring system includes more than 400 sensors placed on various parts of the building, which measures any motion, vibration, and angular deviations. Since tall buildings release more carbon emissions than low-rise structures due to their use of extra heating and cooling devices, it becomes a huge challenge to construct an eco-friendly skyscraper. However, the tower was carefully designed for achieving eco-friendly practices. The building is recognized as the first building in 2017 with more than 100 floors to receive LEED Gold certification from the US Green Building Council. LEED is the main green building rating system used in Korea. The tower is recognized for its eco-friendly power generation facilities and reducing carbon emissions. The renewable energy generated from the tower for electricity is similar to planting 8.5 million 20-year-old pine trees every year. Up to 23,000 tons of carbon dioxide emissions are reduced due to the production of clean and renewable energy in the tower. For the atrium lobby, the tower uses a displacement air and radiant floor cooling and heating system rather than the conventional air conditioning system. Variable frequency drives have been installed to ensure that the HVAC equipment is performed more efficiently. SCADA system has been installed to control and monitor the tower's power use. The largest portion of the tower's renewable energy sources relies on the hydrothermal energy method, which uses a temperature difference between water from the Han River and the atmosphere. The tower contains the largest hydrothermal energy facility in Korea. The hydrothermal facility receives 50,000 tons of water per day and distributes 3,000 refrigeration tons, which reports for 10% of the energy needed for heating and cooling in the skyscraper. The facility operated from the interior of the skyscraper reduces energy consumption by 36% and decreases carbon dioxide emission by 38% in contrast to other buildings in Korea. The production of hydrothermal energy does not need a cooling tower on the roof of the building, making it economical and also reduces noise pollution and the urban heat island effect. Besides the hydrothermal energy facilities, a 20,000 square meter energy center is located on the 6th basement floor. It generates about 12% of its complete energy through geothermal energy system, wind turbines, solar panels, rainwater recycling facilities, and waste heat recovery systems. Water-saving fixtures and grey water reuse facilities allow savings of about 30%. Sustainability features or high insulation glasses, LED lighting, daylight controls, and the use of high efficiency facilities. So, what do you think about this super tall structure? Let me know your thoughts on the comments below. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next one.